The only way we can understand this mystery of improvisation, which is a dynamic process in flamenco, is by getting knowledge. We need to get knowledge. This knowledge we cannot get by just watching videos or doing, that's the way we have to really know. To really know, that's why in Skype I have the course specific from the scratch up to the highest level, and you are welcome to join it. Because yes, it is possible to play. Technique is not a limitation there, which means even if we don't have big scales or anything, but we can produce a sound, right? And when we produce a sound, say, if I play, for instance, suppose I play. Thing to create a solo. I can still create beauty with less speed or anything. In fact, that there are two things, McLaughlin explained it one time, that there are two lines, main lines, that don't have, I was really young, but after a concert with Paco, they were talking somewhere, and I came to listen what he was saying, and he said, there are two main lines, you know, this. One line is the musical economy thing, which is to play with very few notes, and the other is the Coltrane line, which is very virtuosistic with fast stuff and that. And I like both, and I explore both things, he said. So in fact, Paco de Lucía tried to do one of these musical economy things, which you know is there. You know? So the more thing has few notes. And although harmonica is pretty complex, but that was his intention. He said, I want to make one piece that doesn't have fast runs or speed pick out like that. And he ended up doing that. So the thing is that these two lines of virtuosistic stuff or with less notes, that is because there is four possibilities you can do. You can do good music with many notes, and also bad music with many notes. And you can also do very good music with just few notes and bad music with just few notes. So the resources you have, this is fourth possibility there. And out of these four, we should aspire to do good music either with many notes or with not so many notes, but good music, good taste, and in knowledge. Improvisation is not something that just we sit there and play anything. It's not so random or so cheap. It has to be a stuff. This comes from knowledge, actually, because you need to know the contour, the rhythm, choosing notes, some theory, and what it's about. Paco was able even to improvise falsettos in the spot. In fact, he said that many of the Camarón things he recorded with him, he was improvising everything. Which is true, there are so many things that are not recorded. Some of them were falsettos that he played in his albums, but so many other things were not falsettas playing in his album, but just things improvised there. So therefore, this falsetta playing is something we have to be careful about, because we tend to take that as the all-in-all, and that is not the all-in-all. In traditional flamenco, it was the only, not the all-in-all, but the only thing even. But now, with all these possibilities, and with Paco saying, go for improvisation, everyone should learn it, then you get knowledge. Knowledge about how you play and freedom. Then what are we waiting? We need to do that. Right? And that is not jazz. We're not playing jazz or nor jazzy music. This is not jazz. This is flamenco also. Because after all, at the end of the day, we are playing Soleil, Bulería, etc. We're doing just that. The point is how you do it. And therefore, this is a very interesting topic. Everyone is welcome to join. In Skype, you can get this in no time. Because I found out the shortcut for you.
Mira, yo lo que descubrí ahí es la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico debería a músicos del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música, debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando, de cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías estás en cada momento, ¿no?
Muy bien, Pablo.
Sí, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.